Now, a blizzard warning was issued for the New Hampshire coastline, the Seacoast, this afternoon, where coastal flooding is a concern because of the timing of the storm. Our Gene Mackin has that story tonight from Hampton Beach.
The New Hampshire coast may be under a blizzard warning, but there's barely even a sea breeze out here tonight. It will be a completely different scene come Friday, and especially on Saturday, when this storm combines with the highest tide of the month.
The warning sign is blinking on the way to the beach. Heavy wind and coastal flooding forecasted. The astronomical high tide caused by the new moon is on the calendar for Saturday morning during the heart of the high winds and heavy snow. Goodbye footprints in the sand. Here comes splashover with coastal flooding likely. Add in blizzard condition and it gets the attention of people on the seacoast.
There's been a few times where they have evacuated the beach. I don't know if it'll get to that point, but, you know, we just kind of going to keep warm and keep cover. And
Jennifer Richard will help her parents shovel out in Hampton before she heads to Florida with her husband for a warm vacation.
Going to the Florida Keys while everybody else is going to be freezing, so.
Don't rub it in.
Oh, you're going to be freezing too.
You got that right.
Mm-hmm.
While most seasonal homes and businesses are already boarded up for the winter, some hardy Hampton Beachers are getting supplies to stay put.
It's been crazy. Yeah, people are coming in. We got a whole storm set up. Flashlights, candles, batteries, stuff like that. People buying salt, stocking up.
Earlier in the day, Seabrook police readied their Humvees. They say the military surplus vehicles can help with rescues under tricky conditions.
Looking at possibly up to 2 feet of snow and then water over tidal surges. We can get through water down on the beach and some of the roads.
So Saturday morning's high tide peaks just a few minutes past 10. The main flooding concern will be in the 3 hours leading up to that high tide and the 3 hours after it. In Hampton, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.